Myself, Toral Desai, from SNP IT and RC UMRAG, I here to explain Unit Number 1, Database System Architecture. Contained in this unit, we will discuss about introduction of DBMS, application of DBMS, drawback of file system, advantage of DBMS over file system, and three-level architecture. First, what is DBMS? DBMS stands for Database Management System. We can break it like this: DBMS equal to DBMS plus Database plus Management System. Okay. So first, what is database? Database is a collection of data. And what is management system? Management system is a set of program to store and retrieve those data. Based on this, we can define DBMS like this. DBMS is a collection of interrelated data and set of program to store and access those data in an easy and effective manner. Okay, first, what is the need of DBMS? Database system are basically developed for large amount of data. When dealing with large amount of data, there are two things that require optimization. First is storage of data, and second one is retrieval of data. Okay. Next, what is the purpose of database system? The main purpose of database system is to manage the data. Consider a university that keep the data of students, teacher, course, books, etc. To manage this data, we need to store this data somewhere where we can add new data, delete unused data, update outdated data, retrieve data to perform this operation on data. We need a database management system that allow us to store the data in such a way so that all these operation can be performed on that efficiently. Okay, example of DBMS. Let us see a simple example of university database. This database is a maintaining information, students, course, grade in a university environment. The database is organizes five files. First is the student file, store the data of each students. Okay. Second one is course file, store the contained data on each course. Third one is section, store the information about section in particular course. Fourth one is grade file, store the grade which students receive in the various section. And last one is tutor. Tutor file contain the information about each professor. Okay, next. Popular DBMS software. Here is the list of some popular DBMS software. First is MySQL. Second one is Microsoft Access, Oracle, DBase, SQLite, IBM DB2. Okay, Microsoft SQL Server, etc. Okay, next, most important, what is the application of DBMS? Here, there are various fields where database management system is used. Following are some application which make us of database management system. Use of database management system. First is railway reservation system. In the railway reservation, the database is required to store the record or data of ticket booking, status about train arrive and departure. Also, if train get late, people get to know it through database update. Second application is library management system. There are lots of books in a library, so it is tough to store the record of all the books in register or copy. So the database management system is used to maintain all the information related to the name of book, issue date, availability of book, and its author. Okay. Third application is banking. Most important. Database management system is used to store the transaction information about customer in the database. Fourth is education section. Presently, exams are conducted online by many colleges and universities. They manage all examination data through the database management system. Student registration details, grade, course, fees, attendance, result, etc. All the information stored in database. Okay. Next application is credit card transaction. Okay. Database management system is used for purchasing on credit card and generation of monthly statement. Next, social media site. We all use of social media website to connect with friends and to share our views with the world. Daily, millions of people sign up for these social media accounts like Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus. By use of the database management system, all information of users are stored in database and become able to connect with other people. Next application is telecommunication. Without DBMS, any telecommunication company can't think. The database management system is necessary for these companies to store the calls details and monthly postpaid bills in the database. Next is finance. The database management system is used for storing information about sale, holding and purchasing of financial instruments such as stocks and bonds in a database. Next is online shopping. This day, online shopping has become a big trend. No one wants to visit the shop and waste their time. Everyone wants to shop through online shopping websites such as Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal from home. So, all the products are sold and added only within the help of database management system. Invoice bill, payment, purchase information of all of these are done with the help of DBMS. Okay, next, human resource management. The big companies have many workers or employees working under them. They store information about employee salary, tax, and work with the help of database management system. Next is manufacturing. Manufacturing company make different types of product and sell them on daily basis in order to keep the information about their product like bill, purchase of product, quality, supply chain management, database management system is used. Last, airline reservation system. This system is the same as a railway reservation system. Okay. This system also used to database management system to store the record of flights, departure, arrival, and delay status. I have mentioned very few applications. This list is never going to end if we start mentioning all DBMS applications. Okay. Next. Drawback of file system. Okay. First, we will discuss what is a file processing system and how database management system are better than file processing system. So, what is a drawback of file system? Okay. First drawback is data redundancy. Okay. Data redundancy refers to the duplication of data. Let's say we are managing the data of college where students is enrolled for two courses. The same student detail in such a case, well, we will store twice, which will take more storage than needed. Data redundancy often lead to higher storage cost and poor access time. The first drawback is data redundancy. The next drawback is data inconsistency. The data redundancy lead to data inconsistency. Let's take same example that we have taken above. The student is enrolled for two courses and we have student address stored twice. Now, let's say student requests to change his address. If the address is changed at one place and not on all the records, then this can lead to data inconsistency. Next, data isolation. Because data are scattered in various files and files may be in different formats, writing new application program to retrieve this appropriate data is difficult. Okay, next one is dependency on application program. The changing files would lead to change in application program. Okay, next drawback is atomicity issues. Atomicity of transaction refer to all or nothing, which means either all the operation in transaction done or none. Okay, for example, let's say Raj transfer 100 to Rani account. This transaction consists multiple operations such as debit 100 from Raj account, credit 100 to Rani account. Like any other device, a computer system can fail. Let's say it's fail after first operation, then in that case Raj account would have been debited by 100 rupees, but account was not credited to Rani account. In such a case, rollback of operation should occur to maintain the atomicity of transaction. It is difficult to achieve atomicity in file processing system. Okay, last drawback is data security. The data should be secure from unauthorized access. For example, students in college should not be able to see the payroll details of teacher. Such a kind of security constraint are difficult to apply in file processing system. Advantage of DBMS over file system. Okay, what are the advantage of DBMS over file system? First is no redundant data. Okay, first we redundancy remove by data normalization. No data duplication save storage and improve access time, data inconsistency and integrity. As we discussed earlier, the root cause of data inconsistency is data redundancy. Since data normalization take care of data redundancy, data inconsistency also be taken care of as a part of it. Next is data security. It is easier to apply access contain in database system so that only authorized user is able to access the data. Each user has difficult set of access. Those data is secure from the issue such as integrity left, data lack and misuse of the data. Next one is privacy. Limited access means privacy of the data. Okay, next, easy access to data. Database system manage data in such a way so that the data is easily accessible with fast response time. Next is easy recovery. Since database system keep the backup of data, it is easier to do a full recovery of data in case of failure. And last is flexible. Database system are more flexible than file processing system. Okay, next topic is what is the disadvantage of DBMS? DBMS implementation cost is high compared to the file system. Okay, the complexity, the database system are complex to understand, and performance. Third one is performance. The database system are generic, making them suitable for various application. However, this feature affect their performance for some application. Next topic is three-level architecture. Okay, this architecture has three level. In this figure, you can see three level. First is external level, second one is conceptual level, and third one is internal level. Okay, first level, external level. It is also called as view level. The reason is level is called view is because several user can view their desired data from this level, which is internally fetched from database with the help of conceptual and internal level mapping. The user doesn't need to know the database schema details such as data structure, table definition, etc. User is only concerned about the data, which is what returned back to the view level after it has been fetched from database. This is the highest level architecture and closest to the user. Second level is conceptual level. It is also called as logical level. The conceptual level is higher level than the physical level. Okay, this level is maintained by DBA. What is DBA? DBA is called as database administrator. The full form of DBMS is database administrator. Okay, the whole design of database, such as relationship among that, schema of data, etc., are described in this level. Database constraint and security are also implemented in this level of architecture. It is a middle level between external or internal level. And last one is internal level. It is also called as physical level. Okay, this is the lowest level of architecture. This data is stored in external hard drive in a form of bits. Okay, this level described how the data actually stored in storage device. This physical level also discuss encryption technique. Okay, and this level is also responsible for allocating space of data. Okay, thank you.